Let's talk about naming aldehydes. So if the aldehyde functional group is your highest priority group among all the groups in your compound, then we're going to name that compound as an aldehyde parent chain with the suffix al at the end of the name. If there's a higher priority group on this list that's in your compound, we'll name it as, say, an ester or an acid halide or an amide, one of those higher priority groups as the parent chain, and then the aldehyde will be subjugated to a normal group. If it's included in the parent chain, it will be an oxo group, and if it's off of the parent chain, that aldehyde will be a formyl group. Okay, so we're going to be careful every time we name systematically to circle the parent chain on our paper. We're going to write the names of the subordinate groups that intersect that circle to be careful again. Number the chain so that the right numbers end up with the right groups, and we're going to assemble the name, checking for stereochemistry to make sure we don't miss out anything in our name. So let's practice where the aldehyde is the highest priority group. So it's got to be included in the parent chain, and we're going to get as many alkenes and alkynes as we can. Here we can get all of them, and we end up with one group intersecting the parent chain. That alcohol is a priority group unless it's in the presence of something higher, aldehydes higher, and so we're going to end up subjugating this alcohol to a hydroxy group. Whenever alkenes and alkynes appear in the parent chain, they get special treatment. They get the suffixes ene, ine in that order, with the final group being the highest priority group. So ene, ine, oles, ene, ine, amines, ene, ine, al in this case. And so we'll put numbers where appropriate now on these groups. The highest priority group gets the lowest number automatically, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6 overall here. We do have two elements of stereochemistry. One's a chiral center at carbon 2, oxygen being the highest ranked group with the greatest atomic number, the first atom attached. Then carbon to two oxygens beats carbon to two carbons. Hydrogen's going back is group 4, where it's supposed to be for our assessment of RNS. That's clockwise, so this is a 2R stereocenter. And then next door, we have an E, opposite sides with the highest ranked group, double bond. So if we're going to put this name together, we'll include that stereochemistry out front and first in our name. And in order of appearance, we have a 2R. We don't need the 2 because there's no confusing R's and E's, double bonds and chiral centers, okay? So we have RE in order of appearance, and then the only group intersecting the parent chain circle is the hydroxy group. It's a 2-hydroxy. And then finally, 6 carbons is a hex. How many or where are our locants for our priority groups here inside this circle? We have an ene, a 3-ene, and a 5-ine, and then the highest ranked group is an al. We don't need a number because aldehydes are always at the beginning of a parent chain when they're the highest priority group, so it's redundant to put the 1. We leave that all. So ene, ine, al, 3-ene, 5-ine, al. We could also have written this with the first locant of the suffixes here out front, hexene, 3-hexene, 5-ine-al, with a dash, separating all letters and numbers. Now, when multiple aldehydes are present, such as this first example here, a simple one, we number our chain. It's symmetrical either way, left or right, and it's a pentane. Instead of pentanal, we have a pentane dial. So the E goes in to separate the consonants N and D to make it easier to say. Okay, we look at our next example here. We've got a little more complicated of a group, so I'm going to go ahead and circle the highest priority groups, these two aldehydes, make sure they're in our parent chain. Any group intersecting the circle gets a name. And then we have stereochemistry in our double bonds. We have an E here with opposite groups in the trans position. And on the left-hand side, we've got chlorine is a high-ranked, besides carbon, has a higher atomic number. And then carbon versus hydrogen, high and low, that's a Z stereocenter. So we'll include those in this name as well. So let's put this name together here. Okay, if we can get out there. Perfect. So out in front, we've got two elements of the same stereochemistry. So we do need numbers now. I'm going to go ahead and number this parent chain here to put the lower number on the first encountered groups. 1, 2 is a tie with numbering for the alkenes and aldehydes. We can go 1, 2 either way, 1, 2, 3, 4 either way. So 1, 2, 3 lowers the chlorine. That's our next tiebreaker there to make sure we get the right numbers in our name. Okay, and so we're going to start by putting the stereochemistry in here at the proper positions. That's a 2Z4E. Looks like we've got a chloro, so a 3-chloro intersecting the circle. And then with 2 alkenes, we have a hexa, 2, 4-diene, and then a dial. Well, because of the dial, we need an E to separate the consonants, N and D. So we put the E back in, 2,4-diene-dial. It's given that the aldehydes begin and end the parent chain. And so we've got everything there located. We could have also have, again, brought the numbers out front for the first suffix. Our 3-chloro doesn't change. Only the parent chain ordering here, the 2,4, can come out, and we'll put hexa, diene, dial. Again, that A goes in there to separate the X and the D as well there. That's a convention from alkene and alkyne nomenclature as well. All right, suppose the aldehyde is not the highest priority group. Here, we have a nitrile that is. And so now that aldehyde doesn't go into our circle. It's a group, and it's an oxo group. The hydrogen's trivial, doesn't need a group name, okay? Oxo does need a group name, and it's the aldehyde being part of the parent chain, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Carbon 5 of the parent chain, it's an oxo group, not a formal group. The 1 of the nitrile goes in for nitrile nomenclature. So we'd call this a 5-oxo, no stereochemistry to be had, pentane nitrile. 5-oxo pentane nitrile. If the aldehyde is not on the parent chain, and so the longest carbon-to-carbon chain containing the highest priority group here, our carboxylic acid is greater than our aldehyde, just like in the previous example, our nitrile was greater than the aldehyde, we would get the longest carbon-to-carbon chain that has that highest priority group. So we put a 1, a 2, a 3, a 4, and a 5. And now, because we're off the parent chain, that carbon needs to be named 4-methyl. It's not included in the number of the parent chain, so it needs a full group name there, and it's a formal group. No stereochemistry indicated at that chiral center, so we don't have to worry about it. It's a 2-formyl pentanoic acid, 2 words there for pentanoic acid, named as a carboxylic acid because that's the highest priority group.